Those of you who watch my junk store episodes would remember this one, and I thought it was only a few months back. It was actually a year ago. This old lady with, it's just an amazing place full of stuff. Well, a couple of weeks ago, I don't know what it was, Friday evening, someone kept telling me, go and see her, go to that shop, go to that shop. Woke up Saturday morning, still that little voice saying, go to that shop. I actually went there in the morning and it was all closed up, and someone was kept nagging at me. I said to Oddie after lunch, do you want to come with me? I'm going to go out there again. I don't know why, someone's drawing me there. And when I went there, she was open, and it was her very last day. She was closing the business up. She's 75 years old. She's had enough. A lot of the stuff had already been taken out. There was a local museum grabbed a lot of stuff. So we're going to have one last final look through, and I'll show you a couple of items that I bought. There's a lot of junk too. There's a lot of stuff that just is going to go into the furnace, I would say. But anyway, let's have a look around for the last time. So, intrepid explorers, put your dust masks on, or your coronavirus mask, whatever you want to call them. Let's head in. Let's head into the dusty cavern. Couldn't find the old lady at the start. Was sort of halfway through, and then she suddenly appeared like a spectre. Yeah, she's a tough old bird. She's not the friendliest of persons, but towards the end I warmed her up and I got a bit of a sweet smile. But I said, you're going to miss the place. No, I won't. I said, what about all the nice people? Oh, there's not nice people come too. Oh well, I think she had enough. 75 years, it's a long time. Yeah, she said they're going to clear the whole place out. I don't know how many skips it will take, but there's a lot to clear out still. I just bought a couple of small things. Oddie bought I bought for Oddie it's a small little side table. Quite nice, I'll show you towards the end. For $50. You know, she was saying, oh, I can get a lot more. I know for a fact the online auctions here, you can pick them up for a couple of bucks. But anyway, I didn't want to argue with her. I gave it to her. I bought some pictures, and I bought a Victorian Post Mortem photograph, which I found in a drawer of a cabinet that had been sort of, there was something in front of it for years, and they pulled it out, and I pulled the drawer open and found this old Victorian postmortem photo, which I'll show you at the end. Tell me if you've seen anything you like. There's a few little nice things. There's a lot of rubbish too, but it's like old rubbish. It's been there a long time. Yeah, I mean, a lot of stuff is just not needed and no one wants it. The young people don't want it. The older people don't want it either. Some of it's been stuff like utilitarian stuff that they've had to use decades ago and they don't want to see it again. They're quite happy with the modern alternative. Old sort of washing plungers, etc. Nowadays they've got fully automatic washing machines with timers. They don't want to go back to that. There's an old, probably about the First World War. There would have been a photo in the middle which has been removed. That thing there, I've got the feeling that's from about the 1980s. I do recall similar things to that. It's a bit dark in some spots. No real natural light. 1926, I think we saw that last time too. It's a shame that nobody wants that. Quite a nice piece. It just shows you the decline in the antique trade. A lot of this stuff would have been hung on kitchen walls years ago in the 80s and 70s. Not really wanted. I don't know what it's like in the US. Do you think this stuff would sell in the US? Or is it also junk there? I mean, this is like tinder, isn't it? Cordwood. These were once all beautiful items. I mean, they're probably going to uncover stuff that's been lost for decades. Once they start clearing out, they might find some good stuff. It's just like stuff piled on top of each other. Though they have cleared a lot out since I was here a year ago. Some of it's like unrecognizable. Had some purpose in its previous existence. Thick dust covering everything. I think I was trying to clean that mirror, it just wouldn't clean, it was so filthy, ingrained grime. There's a shoe last for doing shoe repairs in the old days. Nowadays shoes are so cheap you just throw them away and buy a new pair. All the shoe repair shops have gone out of business, nearly all of them. There's a few left. Ah, Holy Mary, Mother Mary, still giving us a serene smile after all those decades. Hail Mary, full of grace. Also, sadly, things that nobody wants. Yeah, I would be interested to know in your part of the world, is there anything you see there that would sell, that would do well? Now, over the years, I've sort of cherry-picked things that I knew would sell on online auctions. And as I say, the only interesting things that I sort of grabbed today was old frames from the 1920s, which I can reuse for my old photos that I collect, and that Victorian Post Mortem photo. But everything else I saw is just not something you're going to make a profit on, and she's still pretty up there with the prices, even though the stuff's going to be thrown out. Hard to do a deal with her. Tough as nails she is. Tough as nails. What is it? What has she got that price there on that bottle? $25 for an empty bottle. Come on. It's about the equivalent of $25. Who's going to pay that? Yep. Oh, what's that? Is that an old lamp from the right, the brass one from India or something? It's amazing the woodworm hasn't eaten this place away. Yeah, this is the chair heaven, isn't it? All these sort of old Biedermeier sofas. Some of them, well, they do look quite imposing when they've been newly upholstered and restored. You know, these ones here, they look great, you know, in a room with bare polished floorboards. The thing is, most people now want those big bed sofas, you know, those huge things that you can sort of lie on and eat on and live on and do other things on, which are not that comfortable on an old Biedermeier. So that's the reason why they're not really wanted. Stacks of them, all would have been in people's homes about 100 years ago. Nice fabric on that one. A nice pattern. You know, that yes, I caught it last time, wasn't it? The chair graveyard. Yeah. Cemetery. Sofa cemetery. Yep, seen better days. Yeah, but the old lady said she's looking forward to her retirement. She did a lot of furniture stripping over the years, and she said her hands are really knackered. So So she's earned her rest. She was actually brought up on the property next door. It's an ancient old house, and she wouldn't let me film it. She didn't give me an inch. No, she wouldn't let me film it. I think I had the feeling she'd probably been a bit of a hoarder, and I think the house is probably the same. So maybe she was a bit embarrassed. But the house is ancient, a couple of hundred years old. So, yeah, she basically been here all her life. End of an era. She does say she didn't seem sad about it, but I think she would be. She just puts up a tough veneer. I mean, you know, after that many years. And I know that I've seen her when she's in a good mood, you know, regaling away there with the customers. I think she's going to miss that. But a rest, indeed, she has earned. Yeah, this was the same last time. Not much difference here. More of these sofas. Yeah, that pram is unmoved since 1 year ago. Shame that nobody wants that. They used to be quite popular back in the 70s and 80s, of course. And perhaps she's wanting too much for it. And now nobody really wants them. Yeah, I might speed this up. Well, that's a beautiful piece of artwork, isn't it? That lovely, sunlit, dusty cobweb. Beautiful. Months in the making, possibly longer. Who appreciates a spider web? I'm sure some of you out there do. That was a nice old picture, painting frame. Sadly, probably too much, cost too much to restore. Well, you could just stick a bit of gold paint on the parts where the plaster is showing through. You can't even get to that. It's just covered in junk. There's just, who knows what they're going to find behind there when they pull all that out? Who knows? That's if the old lady lets them in. There's no guarantee. She might change her mind at the last minute. Stacks of stuff. 650 for that rotting old wardrobe. Hooly dooly. I'm speechless, my dear viewers. I don't know what to say. I can't see anything. What's that called? Majolica ware? That bowl, that used to be quite popular too, didn't it? It's just too dark here to make anything out. That's an old light fitting. Nothing in there, Oddie. Nothing in there. No gold coins. Not today. You're not going to find that undiscovered Leonardo da Vinci. Back to the drawing board, back to the computer, and make a few shekels. That was an old 40s telephone, or 30s. That's quite nice. Heavy things. Oh, look at that, a metal claw and ball foot. There's a few of them there. Yeah, those telephones are nice. They're heavy, though. You ever used one? Pick them up. If you're chatting away for 45 minutes on the phone, you're going to get an arm ache holding up that receiver. What am I talking about? I have no idea. A nice bit of detailing on that wardrobe. Sadly, it's going in the furnace. And look, there's a wonderful... I hope somebody saves that. It's Japanese. It's a wonderful... It's like a silk... It's like... What do they call those... Screens. What are they called again? Ah, I've lost it. You're going to tell me. I know. You're going to put it in the comment section. What are they called again? A paravent, we call it here. The French word, paravent. I've forgotten the word for the term we use in English. But you know what I mean. It's like three or four panels. You can separate a room with it. Ladies would get dressed in the morning with the help of their maids behind that screen while the husband read the morning paper and smoked his pipe. You know what I mean. Tell me the name of it. Outside, it's hot. It's like it's steamy in here, I'm telling you. Steamy, really hot. No breeze coming in. Just baking dust and baking Oddie. She says the place has already been sold. So I'm wondering, have they sold it for the land? I can't imagine anybody attempting to restore this place. It's just like a big old shed, isn't it? A barn. So I'm assuming that the land price is worth quite a bit, and they're going to raise it all and build an apartment block there. Something that's going to make modern people money. That's what it's all about nowadays, making money. More money. Inherit money, invest it, rip down your parents' beautiful or your grandparents' beautiful old house and build a big block there, big concrete block. Stick as many people in as possible, tiny little balcony space, and cash in, ka-ching, ka-ching. Make that money before you die. Ah, it's been a long day, my dear friends. It's been a long day. I'm rambling. Oh, I've got these old scales. I've got a pair of them. Don't know what to do with them. Don't know why I bought them. I use them as weights. George Maurer, Kettenhaus, Rosenbach or something. That's the day of the old department stores when they had actually wooden coat hangers. They went to that effort. 1918, the toggly calendar. Well, we're coming to the end. And I've just about run out of things to say, my dear viewers. Before we go, the old lady was trying to sell me this old religious sort of diorama made out of wax. You're going to see it in a minute. I thought about it. Apparently it's musical too. It's wind up. She says you just need to oil it and it'll work. And she's trying to convince people. And I thought, what am I going to do with it? What am I going to do with it? You have a look at it. Should I have bought it? I decided no. Maybe I was wrong. You have a look and tell me what you think. Here it is. It's Joseph, Mary, and baby Jesus, I think. Jesus, Maria, and Joseph. So yeah, baby Jesus. Well, as a young boy. Yeah, so it's all done with sort of satin and nicely. They would have hung this up 100-odd years ago. Religious families. It's quite nice. It's covered in filth. It's been up on the top of a wardrobe for a long time, but what do you do with it? Should I have bought it? Would you have bought it? Let me know. So this is the dish that Odette got. It's what I call a Victorian dust catcher. All those little bits in it was covered in filth. I had to get the compressor on it. I didn't even bother with that part. But she loves it. She wants to put a sewing machine on it, so I guess it suits the purpose. So this is the Victorian Post Mortem photo of a child that I found in the drawer. Quite sad. Some would think probably quite gruesome nowadays, but they were very common back then. There was a lot of infant mortality, and yeah, so they wanted something to remember their little ones by. And also, it wasn't just children. Adults died too. Often they would pose the husband or wife next to the dead body. Same with the children. They'd pose a living child next to the dead one, try to make them look lifelike. Sometimes they'd stand them up. It was just something the Victorians did. I guess they were quite morbid. But now we can look back in curiosity at their... They didn't see anything morbid in it, I guess. This was photography, and they used it for the purpose. It was quite new to them. What a perfect way, they thought, to remember their loved ones. Nowadays, they're actually quite collectible. There are people there who collect all sort of this post-mortem, memento mori is the Latin word or term for it. This one is actually from Zurich. You can see the photographer's stamp there embossed. So it's a Swiss one. Anybody who's interested wants to make me an offer, they can buy it. I don't really have any particular need for it. It's just I wasn't going to let it go, go to the tip. And it's been hidden away for decades, obviously, in that chest of drawers. You can see the back of the frame is still sealed. It's the original frame, never been touched since it was made. So this caught my eye just as I was about to leave. It was in a box of oddments, and I grabbed it, paid her, and it just caught my eye. I didn't know anything about it. I couldn't see anything on the back at the time until I got the magnifier on it, but it's some sort of emblem. I immediately thought car emblem. I still think it might be, but I have no clue as to which car or which model. It's actually wonderfully made. Inside, it has, it's like sort of, it has dimensions. It's like those old kaleidoscopes you had as a kid, you know? It's sort of mirrored inside, and when you move it around, it's fantastically made. And somebody went to a great deal of effort to manufacture this, so I'm just so curious about it. Anybody out there who has relatives or friends or you yourself, if you know about American cars, I'll get into where I think it's from and where I know it's from. Please let me know which car this is from. Is it from a car or is it from a bike? Now, on the back, I looked under the magnifying glass and there is, it says General Detroit. So it's either General Motors Detroit or General Detroit was also a company that manufactured fire engines and fire extinguishers, but I don't think it would be from that. So was there a car with this emblem on? I'm getting the feeling, I don't know, 50s, 60s, 70s for this emblem. Anybody out there, please ask your relatives, ask your friends, whoever is a big American car fan from that era, if they know what model this car is from. I had a look on the internet, couldn't find anything. Is it a prototype? I don't know. I'd love to hear any information if any of you guys out there know anything about it. Appreciate it. All right, I think that's about it. I'm going to wrap it up now. Love you and leave you. I'll catch you next time. We're going to head off to Italy in a few weeks' time, hopefully, if the borders stay open. I'm going to try and do and see what I can find there of interest for you guys. Hopefully we can find a junk store or two. Keep your fingers crossed. I'm going to try and hit that abandoned hotel again. I'm going to see if I can sweet talk that cantankerous security guard. You remember, I don't know if you remember, I think it was 2015, I videoed inside. I snuck around and got caught. But this time I might bribe him with a few silver pieces. Who knows? Well, keep your fingers crossed anyway. All right, catch you later. Bye.